Hello, it's Jang here with a new buildable First Order Stormtrooper. This is over 9 inches tall, so comparing it to a First Order Stormtrooper minifigure, it absolutely towers above. And this armor system and building system in general goes really, really well with the look of a Stormtrooper, or before that, a Clone Trooper. 81 pieces seems like kind of a lot for one of these buildable figures, but a lot of those parts actually go into small details. This is one interesting little difference that they have compared to previous builds with a kind of brick-based rear calf muscle design right there with a little bit of softness that they bring in, a little bit of shaping. Most of this is pretty straightforward though. It's the body actually goes together in a very straightforward and simple way. You can see from the back they used the oldest of large body armor pieces, but beneath that the skeleton is very simple and just uses a single torso piece, and all the things just snap on in the traditional way. This helmet is pretty fantastic to me. I love the shininess that LEGO gets into their parts. The overall shaping here is really good. Might be a little bit pinched towards the top, just a little bit, but that may be just a little bit of bias in me, but I think it's a really good translation of this overall design to this building system, which still has just a little bit of comic design to it, but a lot of realism as well. And I really appreciate the texturing they got into the black area there and just how fine a lot of these details are, including up here on the top. The standard issue style of blaster rifle has a brand new, large, specialized piece as a housing for the whole thing, but it still has a fair number of parts that get built onto it and into it, including a spring-loaded shooter that's built into it. This is all studs upside-down construction for the forestock and actually getting the spring-loaded shooter main body piece inside of there. So the black outer piece actually has upside down studs at the top of it on the inside that everything gets attached to, and that's a spring loaded shooter in there, and you get a spot to hold an additional laser bolt. Now it has a working trigger. You can't actually move the fingers on these figures, but you can use your own finger. Unfortunately, the trigger mechanism would look best like this, but you need to add a little bit of extra weight to the base in order to make that happen, and they don't include a piece to do that. But if you do get this set up the correct way, you can shoot straight out, and these work really well. And this is a perfect application, I think, of this spring-loaded shooter design that LEGO introduced a year or so ago, and it works great for this figure.
Rebels, blast them!
The figure also has a pistol as a sidearm, which I just realized I had originally attached the wrong way. This is a fairly simple build. It actually attaches fairly securely right to the edge there, but that becomes the handle, and you can just swap that directly out. You just have to remove this axle to get that into the hand of your figure. So if it runs out of battery on the original one, on the rifle, or loses the rifle for some reason, he still has a backup. With the simple skeleton build, the posability of this figure is excellent, although it is a little bit lacking in friction in the knee joints, I found, so you have to fiddle around a little bit to make sure that your figure is balanced. Sometimes it'll start to buckle at one side if you don't have even pressure on both sides, both legs. But overall, to me, this figure shows that LEGO belongs in the action figure space. This is something that I feel could be a worthy replacement for traditional action figures. It has the action with the posing and the shooting, and it has enough realism. It doesn't look like a LEGO derivative that's going way off in a direction of abstraction with the appearance of things. This is very proper. Though the build is fairly simple, this is one of my favorite LEGO action figures to date. And on that bombshell, it is time to end. Please do share your thoughts, what you think about this set and this figure, by leaving a little comment down on the video if you'd like to. I'd appreciate that very much. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.